double integrals. So whenever we want to change the variables in the given double integral, we want to convert the given variables x and y in terms of two other variables, either u, v or polar coordinates. So at that time, what we do first is we find the Jacobian term, and here we are essentially replacing the variables x and y with respect to u and v. So therefore, in the change of variable integral formula, the order will be dx dy replaced by du dv depending on this Jacobian, right? So to do the change of variable, what we do is first we replace x and y by the functions in terms of u and v here, and we take modulus of whatever Jacobian we get. So Jacobian is the determinant, so it is a real number. Its modulus we substitute here, and then we find the corresponding region t in the uv variables, right? So whenever, so first example we have seen that is the polar coordinates. So in polar coordinates we have found the Jacobian is always r. So that means this will be the formula always for the polar coordinates, and whenever we have a region like circular region, we can use polar coordinates. So one example we discuss, and after that the next example in terms of non-polar substitution. So here the function was given, in which to simplify the integration we substituted x plus y is equals to u and y minus 2x equals to v. And then what we have done is first we have simplified these because we need to find the Jacobian, which is del x y in terms of u and v. So what we have done is we first converted x and y in terms of u and v in these two equations, and then we found the Jacobian. So always this may not be possible, right? So suppose we take some substitution like this, then every time it may not be possible to convert the variable x and y in terms of u and v. So what we do is instead of doing this particular step, we can directly find the reverse Jacobian. So what do I mean by reverse Jacobian? So let me write down that. So here we found the Jacobian xy in terms of uv. So instead of that, if we find the Jacobian of u and v with respect to the variables x and y. So let us see what is the Jacobian. So let us first write down the relation between Jacobians. So the relation, so in the substitution, whenever we take x as a function of u and v and y as a function of another function of u and v, in this substitution, the relation between Jacobian so basically we can find two Jacobians here. First is del uv divided by del xy, the other one is del xy divided by del uv. So in the first Jacobian, we partially differentiate u with respect to x and y and v with respect to x, y. And in the second Jacobian, we differentiate x and y function with respect to u and v. So both of these are determinants, that means they are real numbers. So the relation between these is, the first Jacobian is inverse of the second number, right? So let us verify that for the previous example. So in the previous example, we have equation for substitution. So let us recall what was the substitution. That was x plus y is equals to u, and the other substitution was y minus 2x is equals to v. So we found the Jacobian xy with respect to uv, that was 1/3. So we know that the Jacobian of xy with respect to uv, which we have found, was 1/3. Now let us find out the other Jacobian and let us see whether this we can verify this equation for this particular example. So we know that this Jacobian is this one. On the other hand, the other Jacobian is del uv divided by del xy. So by the formula itself, it will be partial derivative of u with respect to x, u with respect to y, then v with respect to x, v with respect to y. Right. So what is our substitution? Our substitution is u is equals to x plus y. So that means the partial derivative of u with respect to x is 1, with u with respect to y is 1, with respect to x is minus 2, with respect to y is 1. Right? So these are the partial derivatives. And then we solve this determinant, then that will be 1 minus minus 2. So essentially we get the number 3. So now we can easily see that this Jacobian is inverse of 1/3. Right? So this is the result. It happens for every substitution whenever our functions are partially differentiable one times. So what we have done here is we have converted the substitution in terms of this equation to get this particular Jacobian. So now if we don't want to convert, or sometimes if we are not able to convert x and y functions variables in terms of the function of u and v, we can directly find this Jacobian, the other Jacobian, and this will be the inverse of it, right? So therefore this equation helps in such a cases. So this was regarding the relation of these two corresponding Jacobians. So today, next what we want to discuss is integration of three variable functions now. Three variables function with respect to dx, dy and dz. So let us recall what we have discussed in the two variable functions. So in the double integral, we essentially discuss three methods. The first method was Fubini's theorem for the rectangular region, then Fubini's stronger version, and the third was substitution method. Right, so all these three methods we will study for the triple integral now. Thank you. So let us first start with the Hugin's theorem for the extension of rectangular region. So this theorem says that if we have a continuous function on the instead of rectangle, now we have three-dimensional rectangle, that means rectangular box. Let us say that box is AB cross CD cross RS. Right, so this is three-dimensional, the interval we are taking cross product three times. So X belongs to A to B, close interval, Y belongs to close interval CD, and Z belongs to close interval RS. So in this case, we can easily extend the Hugin's theorem, and what we get is the given function of three variables. Now, instead of the region, now we have a three-dimensional rectangular box. So box has a volume. Therefore, we call this integral to be the volume integral instead of area integral. And the value of this triple integral is essentially, we will integrate first with respect to x, dx, dy, dz, where limit of x is from a to b, c to d, and R to S. Since it is a rectangular box, this also equals to dy, dx, dz, and this also equals to, so whatever order we interchange the variable. It doesn't matter. So if we integrate first with respect to y, the limit of y will come first, then x limit will be coming, and then z limit will come. Similarly here, the z limit first, limit of y, and then limit of x. Right, so this is possible because our region is of this type. Right, rectangular box, otherwise we cannot do this. So let us see one example. So evaluate the triple integral. X, Y, Z square dV, where B is the rectangular region, x, y, z, such that x is between 0 and 1, y is between minus 1 and 2, and z is between 0 and 3. Right, so I write z in this way, so do not confuse with 3. That is the way I write z. Okay, so what we will observe first here is that our given three-dimensional set on which we are integrating the function, that is B, and that B is a rectangular box because the limit of x, y, and z between constant numbers, right, between fixed numbers. That is the first observation. So therefore, we can apply the Hugin's theorem. So since B is a rectangular box, we can apply Qubin is zero to evaluate this integral. So to evaluate this integral, that means triple integral over b of the function x, y, z square dv, you can straight away integrate by substituting the intervals. So this will be x, y, z square dx dy dz. The limit of x is between 0 to 1, y is between minus 1 to 2, and z is between 0 to 3. Right? So this will be essentially, we can even separate the variables also in this case, because x, y, and z square is the function. So if we integrate first with respect to x, what we get is x square by 2, the limit is 0 to 1, y z square dy dz. So that would be half of y z square dy dz. So now we can integrate y. So essentially we get y square by z square divided by 4, right? So multiplying basically by y square by 2, and the limit of y is from minus 1 to 2. So we have to be careful which variable limit we are substituting, and when we substitute this, we can see that the function is y square. So the difference between 2 square and 1 square is 3. So that means we get 3z square by 4, integration 0 to 3 dz. And essentially we can integrate this, we get z cube divided by 3 will cancel with 3, and the limit is 0 to 3. So essentially the final answer is 27 by 4. So this is a straight away integrating over the given integral. But in the substituting values, we have to be careful. We can't substitute the value of y in the z variable. We have to substitute the value of y in the y variable only. So this is a straight away method and very simple. But now the question is that what will be the stronger version of Fubini in this case? So if you recall the Fubini's stronger version, then in the Fubini's stronger version, we have two type of integrals, type 1 and type 2, right? So in type 1 integral, we have the constant values of x, and for y we have two curves, y equal to fx and y equals to gx, and the region is between y equals to fx and y equals to gx in between these two curves. And the other type 2, we have x as a function of y, and the limit of y is a constant number. So in two variable case, we have two types of region, type 1 and type 2. So now we are going to type 3 case. So here basically we have Fubini's stronger version. So in the stronger version, we have three types of integral, type 1, type 2, and type 3. So that depends on which variable among x, y, and z we are converting as a function of other two variables. Right? So, so what we will do here is, here we have a three-dimensional object as a region. Then two variable function, we have a region, that means the set which is bounded by circle or between two curves. But here we have basically three dimensional region, so something like this. Okay, so this is our given three dimensional region, and so if you want to integrate the function f of x, y, z over this region, what we will do first is we will project this three-dimensional region in two-dimensional plane. So for example, depending on what E is given, so suppose E is given as three-dimensional object, three-dimensional set, where x, y is in T, right? And yeah, so what we'll do is such a three-dimensional set, we can either project in x, y plane or y, z plane or x, z plane, depending on what is the given set E. So here, by the diagram, we can see that it is easy to project this object in the x, y plane. So if you project the object in x, y plane, we get some particular shadow of this object that we will call D. Right. So what is D? D is the projection of the given region in three-dimensional case, which we are projecting on the xy plane. So that means E we can write as a xy belongs to D, such that our value z is between two curves, u1 and u2. So this will be more clear when we'll see some examples, but before that, we need to explain this, what mathematically it happens. So, what is D? So here D is the projection of set E in the xy plane. So now we can see that D is basically the region in xy plane, and now since D is in the xy plane, we can first of all write this integral as double integral of triple integral of E of the function xyz as a two integrals. First integral is over D, and the other integral is over z is from u1 to u2. Of the given function, right, first with respect to z. Now you can see that the remaining integral is area integral over D, and then we know that D is the region in the xy plane. So we can use the stronger version of Fubini to evaluate this double integral. This is actually double integral over D. So that means we can either convert this D as a function of x or function of y. So suppose we convert as a dx dy, so that means x is a function of y. 2x is a function of psi y, and then we have a constant limit of y. So this method essentially we are going to use for the Fubini's stronger version. Whenever our region E is given as a z in terms of two function of x, y, right, depending on what is the given region E in three dimensional case. Okay, so let us take some example which will help us to. So type 2 and type 3, so this is basically type 1. Yes
sir, aapne sir ye x aur y ki limit kaise lagayi hai sir?
X and y, yeah, so that I am saying that D, this given region D is now in the xy plane, right? Shadow of E is D in the xy plane. So that limit of x and y is essentially the limit of D. So let me briefly write down here. So where, what is D? D is basically xy such that x is between phi y and psi y, and our value of y is between P and D. So this D region, we are essentially applying the Fubini's theorem, stronger version of two variable case. So that means D we can convert either as a function of x as a function of y, or y as a function of x. So depending on what is the region D.
Okay, sir.
Right. So here I have mentioned x as a function of y, but it can be y as a function of x also, depending on what is the example.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so now let us see some example, so we'll get some better idea. Yeah, so any more doubt? Joel?
Sir, no doubt, sir. By mistake.
No, it's fine, it's fine. Yeah, so so in this example, we want to evaluate the triple integral of the function z where we are given the region, three-dimensional region E to B, the solid tetrahedron, bounded by four planes. So here, so in two variable case, we have seen that usually the region is bounded by curves, but now this is a three dimensional region, so usually it is bounded by surfaces. So surfaces means sphere, plane, all these are the surfaces. So we have four planes, that is x equals to 0, y is equals to 0, z equals to 0, and the third plane equation given is x plus y plus z is equals to 1. So we'll try to draw this three-dimensional object, and then we'll see where to project, whether we need to project it into xy plane, yz plane, or zx plane, right? So so first of all, we have these three axes, and We have three planes, x0, y0 and z0. So x0 means yz plane, y0 means xz plane, and z0 means xy plane. Right? So that means essentially this region is the part when x is positive, y is positive and z is positive, because it is bounded by x0, y0 and z0. And the third plane which is given, which is x plus y plus z equals to 1. So we can convert this last equation as a one variable in terms of other variables. So usually what we do is we try to convert z as a function of x and y. Right. If you convert this last equation, z as a function of x, y, then what we get is z equals to 1 minus x minus y. Right. So, if we substitute x is 0, then this is basically z equals to 1 minus y. So, that is the line y plus z equals to 1. So that is this line, right? Similarly, if we take y is 0, then we get x plus y, x plus z is 1. So that will give us this line. And in the xy plane, when z is 0, we get x plus y equals to 1. So we get this line, right? So that means this plane z equals to 1 minus x minus y, when it cuts the part x is positive, y is positive, z is positive, we get this object which is essentially bounded by z equals to 1 minus x minus y. So even we can write down these end points. So this is 0, 0, 1, this one is 1, 0, 0, and this one is 0, 1, 0. So this portion, we can see that it is bounded by origin. It goes up to 1 on the z-axis, it goes up to 1 on the x-axis, it goes up to 1 on the y-axis. And this three equation gives us that x, y, z should be positive. Right? So whatever region this one we are getting, is a three-dimensional region, and that is exactly this tetrahedron, because it has four faces. So now the question is that what are the bounds now? Bounds are these four equations, right? Whatever way we have drawn this graph. Because last equation we can convert z as a function of x, y. What is our region? Let us write down. Our given region E is basically x, y, z such that x equals to 0, y equals to 0, and the value of z is between 0 to 1 minus x minus y, right? So essentially we are getting z between two functions of x. Right? This, depending on this region, because z is between 0 to 1 minus x minus y, that gives us the hint that we need to project this region E on the xy plane. Okay, if we convert, instead of z equals to 1 minus x minus y, if we convert x in terms of z and y, so that means x equals to 1 minus z minus y, then we need to project in that particular plane, in the yz plane. But since we have converted, we are looking for this particular equation z equals to 1 minus x minus y, we can project this region in the xy plane. So note that if we project E into xy plane, we get the projected region D to be, so what will be our projection? In the xy plane, so that we can see from the diagram itself. So this three-dimensional object, when we project in the xy plane, what we get essentially is the xy plane part, that is this one. So what is this? So the boundary of this two-dimensional region in xy plane. We have projected this region in the xy plane. So this will be now our D, region D. So what will be the boundary of D? So it is bounded by x axis, y axis, and what is the equation of this line? In the xy plane?
X plus y is equals to 1.
Correct. So D, x plus y is equal to 1. So let's write down that x is 0, y is 0, and x plus y is equal to 1. Now we got our region in two dimensional. So what we are getting is x is 0, y is 0, and x plus y is equal to 1. Let us draw this region in the xy plane. So we got the line x plus y is equals to 1, x axis and y axis. That means our region is this one. So now we can convert y as a function of x or x as a function of y, whatever we like. And we can convert this region D using the Frobenius stronger version for the two variable case. So that means our limit of x will be between 0 and 1, and this equation we can convert y as a function of x. That means we get y is between 0 and 1 minus x, right? So the projected area, we got the limits of x and y, and z limit already we know. So now we can evaluate this integral using the limits of t and limits of z. So let us write down the integral formula. So the triple integral over E of the given function, that is z, is nothing but integral of D, limit of z is from 0 to 1 minus x minus y. Of the function z, dz, over this area integral. And then we know the limit of z as a function of x, y is this one. So you can substitute that here. So that will be double integral 0 to 1 minus x minus y z dz. So the limits we are taking constant limit of x, so that will come outside, and before that we have limit of y as a function of x, that is from 0 to 1 minus x, and limit of x is from 0 to 1. Right, so that is what we are using here. And now this is a simple integral now. So again, integrate this function first with respect to z, then substituting limit of z, then we'll whatever function we'll get is in terms of x and y, which will integrate with respect to y and then with respect to x. Let us find out these limits. So integral of z is z square by 2, and the limit is z is equals to 0 to z is equals to 1 minus x minus y. So this will be essentially half times integral 0 to 1, integral 0 to 1 minus x, 1 minus x minus y square dy dx. And when we integrate this integral, now we need to integrate this function with respect to y variable. So the integral will be, so 1 minus x is constant. So that means this is constant minus y square. So integration of y square is y cube by 3. So that means this will be half integral 0 to 1. And since we have minus y square, the integral will be minus of 1 minus x minus y cube by 3 over the limit y is equals to 0 to 1 minus x. So when we substitute this limit, it will become y is equals to 1 minus x. If we substitute, that term will be 0. So y is equals to 0 terms will remain. So that will be 1 minus x cubed divided by 6 with the minus sign. So minus minus will give us plus. Right. So that will be the value of this integral. And then lastly, we need to integrate with respect to x variable. So that is 1 by 6 minus 1 minus x power 4 by 4. The limit of x is from 0 to 1. So finally, we'll get 1 by 24. So here we need to be careful whenever we substitute this limit. So, yeah, that we need to be careful.